And the XGN. The XGN. The XGN, the XGN. The XGN.
Spirit, live kita diri sa San Pedro Cathedral, San Pedro Street, Davao City, alang sa atong special live coverage sa 4th BEC National Assembly or the Basic Ecclesial Community, atong ginatawag diri sa Mindanao nga GKK. Ug makiguban ka na to karon ang 702 delegates gikan sa 16 ecclesiastical provinces of the Philippines or 86 estimated dioceses and archdioceses. Ug niining ato special live coverage karon mao kini ang opening mass, ang unang adlaw sa upat ka adlaw nga National Assembly. Busa uban kita ni ining opening mass sa atong pagpasalamat sa Ginoo sa maayong pag-abot sa atong mga delegado ug usab ang atong pag-ampo nga mahimo gayong successful kining upat ka adlaw nga BEC National Assembly alang sa kalambuan sa atong mga GKK or ang atong BEC. Ug ang mangulo sa atong Santos sa misa karon mao atong CBCP President ug atong Arsobispo sa Davao, Most Reverend Romulo G. Valles DD. Ang ato ang obispo nga mag-welcome kanatong tanan ug daghan usab obispo nga gikan sa nagkalaiyang archdiocese ug diocese sa tibuok Pilipinas. Busa standby lang mga ka-spirit, kini lamang ang unang adlaw sa ato special live coverage at tangi i-like ug i-share ang DXGN 89.9 Spirit FM dash Davao alang sa ato mga news update. Ako si Maan Uban ng Davao Catholic Herald ug DXGN 89.9 Spirit Team live dito sa San Pedro Cathedral, Davao City. Kini ang 4th BEC National Assembly special live coverage. I Herald.
Rejoices in the Lord as we hold the 4th BEC National Assembly here in the Archdiocese of Davao. This year's theme, Discerning the Challenges of the BEC Journey in the Light of the New Evangelization. Let us all be one in our prayers and thanksgiving, asking the Lord to bless and guide the delegates from the different archdioceses and dioceses, prelatures and apostolic vicariates, religious congregations, together with the Most Reverend Romulo G. Valles, DD, the Archbishop of Davao. Let us all stand and sing praise to the Lord.
Sing to the Lord, sing to the Lord, sing to the Lord, our Lord, our Lord. name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Welcome to this Eucharistic Assembly, the beginning, the start, the formal opening of the 4th BEC National Assembly. Let us then prepare for this holy sacrifice of the Mass by once again recalling to mind our sins, deeply mindful of the mercy and compassion of the Lord. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you.
today is the memorial of Saint Martin of Tours, Bishop. Let us pray. O God, who are glorified in the Bishop Saint Martin of Tours, both by his life and death, make new, we pray, the wonders of your grace in our hearts, that neither death nor life may separate us from your love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Let us be seated for the liturgy of the word.
A reading from the beginning of the Book of Wisdom. Love justice, you who judge the earth. Think of the Lord in goodness and seek him in integrity of heart. Because he is found by those who test him not, and he manifests himself to those who do not disbelieve him. For perverse counsels separate a man from God, and his power, put to the proof, rebukes the foolhardy. Because into a soul that plots evil, wisdom enters not, nor dwells she in a body under death of sin. For the Holy Spirit of discipline flees deceit and withdraws from senseless counsels. And when injustice occurs, it is rebuke. For wisdom is a kindly spirit, yet she acquits not the blasphemer of his guilty lips, because God is the witness of his inmost self and the sure observer of his heart and the listener to his tongue. For the Spirit of the Lord fills the world, is all-embracing, and knows what man says. The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Familiar. Guide me, Lord, along the hem me in and your rest your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me, too lofty for me to attain.
Only, Lord, and all the everlasting way.
Where can I go from your spirit, from your presence? Where can I flee? If I go up to the heavens, you are there. If I sing to the present there,
Lord, on all the everlasting earth.
If I take the wings of the dawn, if I settle at the farthest limits of the sea, even there your hand shall guide me, and your right hand hold me fast.
Let us all stand. Spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Things that cause sin will inevitably occur, but woe to the one through whom they occur. It would be better for him if a millstone were put around his neck and he be thrown into the sea, than for him to cause one of these little ones to sin. Be on your guard. If your brother sins, rebuke him. And if he repents, forgive him. And if he wrongs you 7 times in one day and returns to you 7 times saying, I am sorry, you should forgive him. And the apostles said to the Lord, increase our faith. The Lord replied, if you have faith the size of a mustard seed, you would say to this mulberry tree, be uprooted and planted in the sea, and it would obey you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please remain standing. Be seated.
Brother Bishops, Bishop Joe Cabantan of Malaybalay, the CBCP BEC Committee Chair, Monsignor Manny Gabriel, the Executive Secretary of that committee, Mr. Manny, brother priests, men and women religious, the lay delegates to this fourth BEC National Assembly, mga katawan sa Diyos, gikan sa Davao, nalipay kitag dako nganya kita karong hapuna. Nining atong santos nga misa, mao ang beginning, mao ang start, nining maong assembly. Busa, a warm welcome to all of you to the Archdiocese of Davao. Madayaw nga pag-abot. Maayong pag-abot kaninyong tanan. Salamat sa Dios kay maayo ang inyong pagbiyahe padulong dinhi sa Davao. And thank God for your courage, not discouraged by the recent earthquakes that hit us here, but particularly the many hard hit areas, many BECs in our neighboring dioceses of Digos and Kidapawan. Brothers and sisters, there are 689 of us, delegates, guests, speakers, all in all, 689 with 15 bishops, 193 priests, 52 sisters, 6 brothers, religious brothers, or the other way around, 272 from Luzon, 140 delegates from the Visayas, 200 delegates from Mindanao, and 53 participants coming from special groups, from religious congregations and interested institutions like De La Salle University and delegates from UST. So there are 689 of us. Of course, some are arriving early tomorrow morning. So to all of you, welcome to Davao to this fourth National BEC Assembly. We celebrate this Eucharist this afternoon as our first and our opening activity in this fourth BEC National Assembly. Like in any BEC, in my experience in Mati, in Tagum, in Digos, and in Davao, and in many areas all over Mindanao, the Eucharist is celebrated as often as possible if a priest is available. From experience, our people know that the Eucharist builds the BEC. They may not be able to produce a master's thesis on the truth that the Eucharist builds the church, maybe dili, hindi, but they know by experience that the Eucharist builds the BEC. For as often as we celebrate it, or for as often as BEC celebrate the Eucharist, our collective memory of faith is refreshed and kept alive. That memory that reminds us that the Lord has loved us first before we have even started loving Him. The memory that tells us that each one of us is precious to the eyes of God. The memory that keeps us gathered as a family with one mind and one heart. It is the collective memory that keeps us aware of the code of conduct that sons and daughters of God must keep. The memory that in fact enables us to see and experience the ever-abiding presence of the Lord in our everyday life. And so, a BEC must always be a liturgical community, a worshiping community, as it must also be a teaching and witnessing community, and at the same time truly a serving and shepherding community. Saint Martin of Tours, whose memorial we are celebrating today, is known as the bishop who started the practice of dividing the territory of a diocese into parishes for better pastoral and administrative ministry. Saint Martin of Tours, I would like to imagine, must be smiling upon us these days, seeing that we in the Philippines have continued, as it were, what he began. Now, developing each parish into a communion of smaller faith communities. In 1976, Bishop Joseph Regan, a Maryknoll bishop of the Diocese of Tagum, ordained me. The Diocese of Tagum then still included the territory of what is now the Diocese of Mati. And the Bishop of Mati now is here, Bishop Apigo. My ordination was held in the small and still a small parish of San Isidro, Davao Oriental. Practically, all preparations for my ordination were done through the 38 BECs of that parish. For food, for the welcome arches, and I remember there were 21 of them, 112 altar servers from all BECs. There were envelopes for financial contributions for the celebration, which were coursed through the BECs. Came ordination day, BEC leaders and members were given prominence among the crowd of people who attended the ordination. I am telling you this to underline the fact that I started my life and ministry as a priest in an already much this is not proper English, in an already much BEC-sized diocese. BEC-I-Z-E-D, BEC-sized diocese. I can still remember very well, back in 1976, 1977, the palpable energy and enthusiasm and even healthy competition among priests in our journey of building up and developing our BECs at that time. That is why I am delighted that the 50 years of BEC experience is somehow highlighted in this assembly this week. It started in 1968, and the Jubilee in Tagum was opened last year and closing this year. Last October 24, the death anniversary of Bishop Joseph Regan, I went to his tomb and remembered him in prayer and asked him, Bishop Regan, ang mga GKK is close to your heart. There is a coming National Assembly in Davao. Please bless us and guide us. Today, I have this way of initially describing what the BECs are here in Mati, Tagum, Davao, and Digos. Initial description lang, maybe shallow description. BECs are like jigsaw puzzle pieces that comprise the entire picture of each parish. No BEC pilot areas, no non-BEC areas, the parishes are totally BEC-sized. These days, the Diocese of Mati, Tagum, and Davao are continuing our campaign for help that we bring to the suffering earthquake victims in the dioceses of Digos and Kidapawan. And I am very certain that our campaign for help goes through the parishes and down through our BECs, reaching our people in the far corners of our dioceses. From packs of rice, canned goods, coffee sticks, dried fish, money for tents, powdered milk, and gallons of drinking water, truckloads of relief goods have been sent to the people of Digos and Kidapawan, and more will be sent still. Talk about serving and shepherding character of our BECs. A week ago, I went to the Diocese of Digos and Kidapawan to see for myself what the situation is. Indeed, the situation is bad, sad, and bleak. Bishop Bagaforo met me, and together with the parish priest of the quasi-parish of Quisante in the town of Makilala, he brought me to a number of evacuation camps. One of these was a small cluster of evacuee families, maybe 25 to 30 families belonging to one BEC or JKK. Bishop Bagaforo described this as one of the big number of out of the way, less served or not served at all evacuee families. They were camped on an open grassy area away from the highway, meaning it is an interior location. While talking with the families who met and welcomed us, a man talked to me at the side. While they were talking, he was kind of half whispering to me, telling me of their gratitude to the Lord that no one among them was injured or killed. And he requested me to follow him and see what he got in his family's makeshift shelter. And there, he showed me on a makeshift altar the statues of the Santo Niño, of Our Lady of Fatima, and of San Isidro Labrador. And while recounting to me how he took these statues from the BEC chapel before it totally collapsed, tears were in his eyes. He did not ask me if we were bringing them more rice, foodstuffs, or tents, or any monetary help for the rebuilding of their houses. At that moment, I felt that what he cared for most was to share with me his faith experience. He is convinced that the Lord is present for them and with them during these very difficult times. What strong faith these people have. And I am confident to add and say, these people's faith is greatly sustained and nourished by the life they share together in their BECs. In the gospel reading we have just heard, the apostles, realizing the great challenges they have to face in their journey as the Lord's servants, begged the Lord, saying, "Increase our faith." Maybe this cry of the apostles, I would dare, is a good summary of the fundamental task of our assembly and our continuing task in the days after this assembly. And that is to develop and form and sustain our BECs as communities where the faith of each individual and each family may increase and grow stronger into a faith that moves one to pray and give thanks to the Lord at all times, a faith that enables an individual in ways beyond words and ordinary explanation to see and feel and experience the ever-abiding presence of the Lord in one's life. A faith that inspires each BEC member to talk about his Christian life, to talk about the joy of believing and the joy of serving, or to tell stories of the presence of Jesus in his life. A faith that empowers BEC members to look out and care for each other, to be there for the community, and even to reach out in service and solidarity to those who are beyond the boundaries of his own community. Thus, in this Eucharist and during the days of our fourth BEC National Assembly, we continue to pray to the Lord, asking Him and for our BECs, "Lord, increase our faith."
Let us all stand.
Our general intercessions. Our Master teaches us that discipleship means radical conversion to Christ and rejection of evil, Let us follow the Lord as we live the challenges of our basic ecclesial communities. And let us pray, Lord, let your power be on us.
Lord, let your power be on us.
That the church may be victorious in her struggle, where the basic ecclesial communities are being challenged to fight evil in the world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, let your power be on us.
That Christians may have the courage to speak and act against the evils corrupting our society that affect the moral fabric of the basic cells of the society, the families. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, let your power be on us.
That those who are hardened by sin may be touched by the Spirit of the Lord to repent and change their ways in the light of the new evangelization. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, let your power be on us.
That the sick may be strengthened in their trials and offer their hardships for the conversion of sinners. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, let your power be on us.
That our beloved dead may be led to the company of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, let your power be on us.
Heavenly Father, help us to be faithful stewards of your kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Upon your table, a gleaming cloth of white, the weaving of our stories, the fabric of our
come to your feet.
Let us all stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Sanctify these offerings, we pray, O Lord, which we joyfully present in honor of Saint Martin, so that through them our life may always be directed, whether in tribulations or in prosperity. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of Saint Martin, you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Let us all kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." the mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed, with Joseph, her spouse, and your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Martin de Tours, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Romulo, our Archbishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own.
Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters and all, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Let us all stand.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
but believers.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace.
Let us all kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
sa iyong lubog. Mabuhi siya sa layon.
Mag-awit at maglipay, maghimusa sa pagsabulong tarinigin yung karistiga.
Let us all stand.
Let us pray. Grant to us who have been restored by the sacrament of unity, O Lord, perfect harmony with your will in all things, that just as Saint Martin submitted himself entirely to you, so we too may glory in being truly yours. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. In behalf of the people of the city of Davao, headed by our Mayor, Sara Duterte Carpio, and Vice Mayor, Sebastian Baste Duterte, we call in Attorney Francis Mark Layo, Chief of Staff of the Vice Mayor, to speak before our delegates of the 4th BEC National Assembly.
Good evening. Allow me to read the message of Vice Mayor Sebastian Duterte. To the Archbishop of Davao City, Bishop Romulo G. Valles, bishops, priests, religious men and women, and lay leaders from various archdioceses, prelatures, and apostolic vicariates in the country. Fellow Davaoenos, a blessed evening to us all. In celebration of today's assembly, the Davao City Government extends its deepest gratitude for your choice to hold the 4th Basic Ecclesial Community National Assembly here in our city. We hope that what comes about in your assembly will strengthen the spirit within you and even spread to our Filipino citizens. We, Davaoenos, pray for the continued success of the basic ecclesial communities here in the country. We hope that you will share the enthusiasm and fulfillment in serving the Lord in your fellow Filipinos. May you also keep inspiring others to strengthen their faith through the values and teachings of the Church. And with that, we thank you for inviting us and we wish you luck on your journey. Once again, good evening and may God bless us all.
We may now call in Most Reverend Jose Cabantan, Bishop of Malaybalay, CBCP BEC Bishop in Charge, for some words of welcome and gratitude.
To our Most Reverend Archbishop Romulo Valles, the Archbishop of Metropolitan of Davao, and the CBCP President, our brother bishops, brother priests, brother all men and women religious, and our dear lay people, thank you for coming over to this 4th National BEC Assembly. I would like also to express our heartfelt gratitude in behalf of all of us, delegates from all over the country, to the local organizing committee, the host, diocese or sub-region of Daditama, headed by no other than Most Reverend Romulo Valles, who welcomed us in this assembly. You know, about 2 years ago, I made mention already with Archbishop Moloy about holding our 4th National Assembly here in time for the 50th anniversary of BEC experience here in Tagum and in Daditama. And then 2 years ago, the Archdiocese of Davao just hosted the Mindanao Sulu Pastoral Conference. But when I told him about this, never in his mind that there is a resistance. Openly, with an open heart, an open hands, open mind, he welcomes the gathering of the 4th National Assembly here. We give thanks to them. Of course, we give thanks to all the BECs involved in this National Assembly. And also, we would like also to thank, as we always said, in every gathering here, like the MSPC, they always coordinate with the local government, the city government of Davao. So we would like also to express our heartfelt gratitude to Mayor Sara Duterte, Vice Mayor Vasti Duterte, represented here by Attorney Francis Mark Layo, and also to acknowledge the presence of Councillor Conrado Baloran and Councillor Bayhondra Cassandra Advencola. Thank you very much for your cooperation, and may God bless us all.
Let us all stand.
I would invite all the bishops to join me in blessing you as we conclude this Holy Eucharist. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us bless the name of the Lord, now and forever. Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth. And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Holy Mass has been offered. Let us now go in peace and in the love of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Sa opening mass sa 4th Basic Ecclesial Community National Assembly. Nga aduna kitay partisipante na 700 delegates ato ang mga bishops, religious, and lay na naggikan usab, na usab tay mga delegado naggikan sa special group sa institution o sa congregation all over the Philippines. Busa, niining ato ang pagsugat sa ato mga delegado gikan sa nagkadaiyang lugar sa Pilipinas, atong iampo nga magmalampuson kining ato ang National Assembly nga gi-host diri sa Archdiocese of Davao. Ug mapasalamaton kita usab sa tanan nga mga nagalihok niini. Ug kining maong BC National Assembly 4th adunay temang Discerning the Challenges of the Basic Ecclesial Community Journey in the Light of the New Evangelization. Kini maong opening mass, kini ang unang adlaw sa upat ka adlaw niini maong National Assembly. Busa mga ka-spirits na nagtanaw sa atong live ug nagaminaw sa atong stasyon, sa atong radyo, stay tuned lang po for the 4 days na National Assembly aduna kitay special. special live coverage. Umbang adlaw magsugod ang mga plenary talks nga ihatag sa atong mga kaobispuhan gikan sa nagkadaiyang dioceses o archdioceses. Busa, uban kita ni ining ato ang National Assembly, maskin dili man sa physical appearance, apan tungod diyan natong social media, maabot kita ni ining ato ang pag-celebrate sa 4th BC National Assembly. Ug padayon kita mga ka-spirit sa atong pag-ampo nga magmalampuson ug mag-enjoy ang atong mga delegates diri sa City of Davao ug diri sa Archdiocese of Davao. Ug kini ato ang special live coverage hatod kanya sa Davao Catholic Herald ug DXGN 89.9 Spirit FM. Live diri sa San Pedro Cathedral, San Pedro Street, Davao City. Ako si Maan, I Herald.